map coming in there on which will be part of a rotation later on. But as we're looking at things here on Bind, Eeyore opens things up. No snooze on him as Fat Penguin caught off guard. Paint Shell a bit too late to deny the plant, and that will successfully be put down as Asterisk finds a pick there.
Oh, that's a great start to this, and Asterisk finds a double here, leaving two players left standing. That's BerserX and Lmemore, the two last people here. They do have quite not a lot of time. The spike will be taken away here. That's a good pick. That should probably seal the deal on this round. Lmemore is able to get a couple. There's three people up in there. That recon dart is going to do a little bit of... Nah, I take that back. It's not going to hit the shots here. Awkward for everybody involved. Lmemore almost gets away with murder. Used to be the Blaze and the Burn King show on Boom. But spike this time down, they're sort of leveling up the roster and trying to play a little bit more tactical, a little bit slower. And one thing that we've noticed here about Boom Esports, with Flips Jadur in their roster over Adern King, it feels like they reached a certain level of maturity that just feels so much more tactical, more cerebral. And I think a lot of the discussion is before they, when they made this move, was, does Blaze...
Boom, can they fill this round out in a 3v3 with Tehbotol holding down the line, hopping out from Hookah, and they just meet their untimely demise in courtesy of Tehbotol. Now, he has his elbow control, which can be very hard to flush out if you don't have the proper utility for it, nor the manpower, in which case Boom Esports has neither. For NC Slasher here, he's going to have to do a lot. Trapped between a rock and a hard place here in this Gubby position. He cannot swing out wide, otherwise he might get found by naTz here, who's crawling up behind him. It should be a crossfire in the favor of Alpha, rather AE, who are the Alpha Dogs of this round for the meantime. They will shy it down, utility to work with. They are kind of hounding him here, though, with the slow orbs. He's trapped. And now, with the frag here by Flip Jitter, a trade-off from Asterisk. Tehbotol, he's going to find one, but not enough to really avenge his teammate, as Flip Jitter will be rezzed there, coming from Asterisk, who found a double of his own. Battle Sage, every sense of the word, true and true. Now, 2-1, this could easily be a 2-2 on the board to tie things up for the side of Valdor Ego. BerserX caught out in the open there from Heaven, and this is not looking too well for AE, especially after that Hunter's Fury not connecting.
Yeah, if they don't win this round, and it looks like they won't, they still manage to scrap together a little something, but it's not going to be very much. Alter Ego, they're going to be red here, because Boom, they know this. They know that there's a big disadvantage, disparity in terms of weaponry, and so they're going to wait a little bit more passively to see if anybody pushes them, and they're not going to fall for any tricks right now. They know. These teams know each other so well. This is probably one of the most common matchups, or one of the most historical matchups that we've ever seen for Indonesia, and actually in VCT in general, because these guys have been butting heads for months now.
Mm-hmm. I mean, even outside of the pro circuit, when you, where they're actually like, more than just a single corner between them and the opposition, you just tell, yeah, as you said, like how much space they're willing to give up if it means that they feel they can win the round after that. And because of that, well, that will allow Boom to just calmly walk into the A site itself. Blaze able to open up things, a Blaze here, and Eeyore will chime in, but Tehbotol answering back with a showstopper of his own to find Flip Jitter. It's a big pick here in the favor of AE, but they still do not have that man advantage in their way.
I really like this post-plant setup here that we have right now from Boom. They don't plant default, they go ahead and take showers and even wall off the right side. That just allows them so much more room to get creative with how they deal with the post-plant, with the retake. And look at this, they're going to have to fight so many angles just to get closer and closer. And Eeyore is able to mop up three kills and secure Boom.
5-2 or something like that.
So this is what I like from BerserX. See, this is what he does. He's very good at looking for those opening frags here. Yeah, I don't know about that one either, though. But
that's a bit of a whiff there, Chief. But Fat Penguin landing the shot on the Eeyore once again. Not gonna get caught sleeping. Nat's finding one. The trade-off here from NC Slashers. So he's gonna cut things up and finds a second. He's so good on this Astro, trying to support the rest of the push. But it is down to a 2v3. Caveat here, though, for AE is that Fat Penguin's very low, but still does not mind, finds the opposing Astra, pushing through the divide, and Asterisk is going to get a frag off of that, too. 1v2, he is a Sage, but does not have a heal up online for him. Down to 20 HP, and the Shock Dart to bring the... And just getting kills, and You can take risky plays knowing that you can reconfirm that player after his flip jitter confirms a frag on the naTz. Was, I think, a bit too eager to go for information there. And Eeyore is going to do the same to Tehbotol, getting caught out in the open. Fat Penguin won, but not anymore. The Predator here from Blaze just going to hunt the Penguin down out of the air. This, I like this to come out from them, although the Gravity Well perfectly placed. They knew something was amiss.
Yeah.
But still.
Here, I think they will be. Yeah, that's the wall to deny him, but the Seekers will be pushing alongside naTz. LaRant flips Jadur. Oh, this is an awkward angle to deal with. He's got to get out of there. They maintain the 4v5. And it's a very good pickup here for Alter Ego, because not only have they secured a lot of information, they've also burned the res away. But Fat Penguin looking to do even more. He gets one, followed by naTz LaRant, who's able to finally take down asteriskk, who has been the thorn in the side of Alter Ego. Flips Jadur, working his way around the smoke. He's able to find one here. But he's gonna be berserk to actually find NC Slasher. Nice adjustment right there. Nice reflexes to swat the jump peek. He finds three. That's gonna be three kills. It could be the ace round here for Flips Jadur, the newest member in Alter Ego, proving that he can fill in the shoes of Adern King. And it's looking like he's very close to being able to do it, though. 11 seconds on the clock here.
Just the same as the last time he tried it out, though. But once again, like the last time, will aggress, this time to his untimely demise. They knew he was coming.
They, you know, it's great when your upper, your aggressive upper goes for those peaks. But if you're doing the same thing again and again, to the point where you're starting to get sniffed out, especially by your national rivals, it's very difficult to get away with that kind of stuff. So, adjustment has to be made here for berserk. He can't always go for those same aggressive peaks on B long. You could get away with doing that against teams that don't know that you always do that. But this is Boom. Not only are Boom a top quality team, they're also the team that have been playing with you for like ever.
Like, literally, they know forever, ever since childbirth.
Yeah, ever since the dawn of time, the advent, the creation of man, they were there. Boom Esports.
Big Bam Boom.
Yeah. Exactly. No, that was Vietnam. But naTz LaRant able to get a pick off here. Still a 2v3 on this defuse. They have information. That's a good kill. But still, it's...
But they know that the that comes with a bit of a risk. They can't necessarily just try and go in haphazardly. They have to take things a bit slower with 45 seconds left on the clock. Nats trapped
him, so the good combo utilized perfectly, but a nice shot here from berserk to level the playing field here. And so far he's been hitting, he's gotten another one here. Berserk, he's looking for a third. He gets the reset, still has blades in his hands, and he's got time to work with. 17 seconds left for Boom. They have to make the decisive move. Will they go for the teleport? Not a lot of time to think. They have to clear berserk, who yet again bounces up, but only to find death. For the meantime, Tehbotol with a showstopper, keeping things interesting for now. As Flips Jadur will get that plant. No.
They do know that Alter Ego like making early contact on the opposite side, that they eventually do push, and in this case, they're right on that gamble. But oh no, Flip Jadur could not land the shot. Punched here by Tehbotol from a distance, and Lmemore is going to find one, but he's going to get traded off quickly. Berserk's up close with Asteriskk to get the trade of his own, but it's a 4v2. Make that a 4v1. All on to Blaze is going to have to go fiery hot to bring this one
There's
back.
Five,
look at this triple four. Peak in the sight. There's no chance he could have made trouble in that play. They love popping that gravity well in hookah, then following up with a nade. And Berserk will confirm the kill after Asteriskk was already taken down quite low. And so AE here on the path to getting a 7th round on the board. Flip Jitter, oh, they walk by past him. Will they even expect him to be here on the Radiant? He's going to get the double off of it too. Not checking the angle, not checking the corner. Could potentially find a third, but that nade will keep him out there. But
naTz,
they're making it happen with the Sheriffs laying down the law. And they're suddenly in a 3v1 to their favor. How did they make it happen?
Alter Ego picking up rounds. If they stabilize, they go for the resets. And then they win. They wait, and then they win towards the end of it. But so can Boom, as two great shots on the eco manages to bring us to a 3v2. NC Slasher, to say that he's worse for wear would be a little bit of an understatement. He looks torn up right now, as he's only sitting on to 7 HP.
They've been consistently finding these opening picks, and oh my god.
At this point, map control for some utility, and Flips Jadur looking to be the first point of contact, manages to get around a corner here, but That nade should be enough to take BerserX out. So both of the star players, both of the duelists taking each other's lives in very anime battle style confrontation there.
A bit of a martyrdom coming in from Flipjitter, at least to get that kill post-mortem, so... Oh, it's a nice consolation prize. Left. If I'm gonna go down, I'm gonna bring you down with you at the very least, but Blaze completely blind, good pop flash there, and Lmemore capitalizing on it. Predators, Blaze, Eeyore rather, is gonna find a double, and Fat Penguin and Tehbotol find one apiece. Now, 1v2, he's got the res. Thing is though, nobody really in a position to get res safely. So come down to how he can play this. He's got the heal, he's got the slow orb, that's all he's got to work with. He does spot Tehbotol out, but won't be enough to really confirm the kill. Fat Penguin has been given away and will quite literally flawless. Perfect in every sense of the word here in the second half. Blaze is able to find a double kill. Okay, leading the charge. Even though he was low HP, the res woke up online, and it's exactly what Boom needed in the moment. Asterisk holding it down just to let his teammate successfully get back into the game, but in that chaos, they found their way onto the B side, and Lmemore is able to find one, but Flipjitter and NC Slasher find one apiece as well. Fat Penguin, the last man remaining, far removed esoterically from the site, is nothing to do in this. What can he even apply, and what can he even try? Not much.
This close is very, very worrying for Boom Esports.
Yeah, I mean, when the map opened up, it did seem like a wash in the favor of Boom, but they're proving everybody wrong here. AE, Lmemore finds one, and as they go for two picks apiece on either side, it's down to the 3v3 as the dust settles here on the B site. BerserX finds a pick on a Flipjitter. Now they have control of that B site. They can go for the plant here, looking for a bit of information there. They know that elbow is clear, and that should allow them to plant openly for the meantime, but Boom, we've yet to see a really good successful retake from them here on the defensive side. They have something to work with, but not much. Their shots though, who cares if you don't have utility when you've got aim like Asterisk does.
naTz LaRat is though a little bit
during the group stages and what we see now, you know, especially a while ago with Full Sense, the team that we kind of tapped into to be the second best team in Thailand, who by default should be the second best team in C, have yet to actually win a series here in the playoffs as Flipjitter finds Tehbotol, the opposing Rays, and that's certainly going to set things ablaze here, at least, to start things off for Boom. It's exactly what they needed.
No way Fat Penguin wins it. How does that... Fat Penguin winning that duel in an angle he shouldn't have. I mean, Asterisk already got into a corner that he had no business getting. Nice kill from BerserX. Doesn't even need to dash away. He escapes into the safety of the smoke as Lmemore is able to find one, and BerserX finds another. This is match point here for Alter Ego, and we're going to be seeing an upset. Not off Alter Ego, a little bit off guard.
Okay. Flipjitter keeping them afloat for the meantime. Eeyore going one for one, enough to delay them and really alert the presence here. The defenders inside the site for Boom. Capitalize on it, and Flipjitter a triple kill for Empire Playoffs. That needs to be seen. Oh, BerserX!
Off here as the recon does come in. A couple of rotations will be made here as naTz LaRat looking to get that great timing onto Eeyore. Looking a little bit sleepy on that one. And BerserX misses that right click. Somehow still alive here. And Flipsider will get traded just as quickly. Still, the move has been made. And this is looking like the game here for Alter Ego. Can they defeat the number one in Indonesia and get ahead in this series? It's looking like it as Asterisk. He's got a little bit more left in the tank. 1v3 now as he's trying to creep up towards elbow. They know where he is, but this triangle of doom, this crossfire, there's just no way in hell he's ever going to make this out alive. It's looking like Alter Ego is going to be the ones here emerging victorious, or okay. Will it? Trade frag failed, but the time's ticking away. He can heal himself a little bit, and that's the beauty of having a sage. Flash goes through. That gives information though, but the peak coming out, flat pack.
To keep them alive, Boom Esports hanging on by a thread in the meantime. The thing is, while everybody might be taking steps forward, not everybody takes the same equal amount of steps as Tehbotol and BerserX are taking every step necessary to take this mid control. They found three opening picks, but Blaze, make that Eeyore rather here, finding triple on the site itself. It's all down to a 2v1 real quick. It's all on the Blaze this time. Lmemore very low. BerserX has given his position away, and by that, he should assume that they have a crossfire from the pillar itself. But they do trade situations, trade positions, And honestly, Blaze can make this happen. He is a very clutch player, but he's going to need to find one to make it happen, to make it really close. He does get the low player that are out, Lmemore. BerserX on the swing. It's so hard to get somebody when he's swinging you that wide with a frenzy up close. Oh, he spots a shoulder out, but BerserX is biding his time perfectly. The sands are slowly hollowing away here for Blaze, and up close, you're not going to win that fight. Not against BerserX with a frenzy.
In fashion against Boom, that will rock everybody's world in the local and the international scene.
Yeah, I mean, I have to agree that if they can take this, then by all means, they are the new kings of Indonesia, but they're going to have to prove that first, and we can't really call the action before it happens. Boom Esports still deserve the benefit of the doubt, and they're going to be looking to prove themselves as Predator. Blaze, I keep saying his name the other way around because he's got me topsy-turvy. I know this man is prime time, but hasn't been enough to really get them a win here in the series so far. As Blaze finds one of his own, it's quick to make that a 1v4. Everything crashing down the foundations of this post plan. Not really working out for them
internationally.
I mean, Boom are at 66, so it isn't that big of a difference, but right. The performance speaks.
The flash actually seemingly working against them in that spot, but Boom's NC Slasher. That's going to be a nice double here as he lines up two and is able to get a very significant hold onto that B heaven area. We'll force them out towards A here, and yet again, Alter Ego are making the right reads. They're committing two of their remaining players here on towards this A. But will they expect this push right now? The wall could come up. They are ready for it. That's going to be the Rolling Thunder, and that's going to be catching them off guard. But the flank from effort right there from Flip Jabir and such awareness. Good shot for Lmemore, but that's all he finds. Again, more respectful place here. But the Slasher, oh, he actually gets decapitated right there with a judge in his hands. You would think that he... BerserX does have the Blade Storm in his hands. That's a good follow-up right there for Lmemore to help him secure Heaven. Good flash, but it matters not. Because Lmemore gets a triple here, denied with a judge here. And that's going to be the lockdown to slow down the pace for now, because it's still a 1v3. They're not going to be too scared about it. They're both reading each other. This is the double read. This is, I'm telling you, man, this is like super chess right now. The double spray down from Predator's Eeyore. And he's going to be able to get another one, but he's going to book it all the way to A, naTz Lorant here. He does have a wall. He does have 8 seconds. He's going to be allowing himself to plant for it's going to be close, but he's going to get it for sure with 1 second to spare. And it's going to be still a 1v1. Has a res, fortunately for him. Now he's brought it back here. And of all the players that you could have rezzed, BerserX, that's a great choice.
Fortunately for him, he's got the Blade Storm as well up online. And on the peak, you're going to have to slowly do it, trying to... Well, dash in here from BerserX. He's going crazy at it, and wow. He finds a Flip Jitter. Perfect read, perfect timing, and perfect angle to get it. But Blaze, he's able to find one. A quick trade-off from Fat Penguin, though. Smile and wave on the drive-by. It's a quick 4v3 already. Mid-control season taken. Boom Esports. Quick to rescind it, though. They do have that Eeyore player here on the Killjoy. Specifically on the A site alone. Asterisk and
site. And that's still definitely not an easy thing to do. That's Eeyore, his spot. He's very much known. And Lmemore's going to hit another banger of a shot. That's awkward. NC Slasher. They bypass each other in the smoke. Lmemore's left stunned after that one. The show has been stopped for him as we find ourselves in a 2v2. No ultimates to be utilized this time. As Fat Penguin, he spots information onto one. He's able to swing. The flash was not good, but with 55 HP. It's a big round coming up here for Boom if they can make the right read. Can they hold on? It looks like Asterisk will play up close. He gets a double. He doesn't get a third. That's going to be the neural theft there, availing them of information. Very crucial here as Blaze looking to dip and dodge around that corner. The backup coming to support him. Lmemore has managed to work his way up close and is not going to be able to get anything down because Blaze, he's right there. No res is available. Well, he does, but I don't think he'll be able to get in range here. The bodies are being watched carefully. Nice shot. Adjustment to punish the jump peak. But an even nicer shot from NC Slasher making the... It might just salvage this half just yet. But Rolling Thunder No chance. Eeyore never gets out of that. He just gets knocked up, and he ends up on MTV. That is Blaze as well, getting taken down here with a beautiful double swing out there towards mid. NC Slasher is able to respond, but it's still a 2v3, and a lot of information given for Otzel Ego. They're going to be heading towards B, nobody waiting for them, but they could be at risk of a flank coming in as two players here for the side of Boom. They're going to be working their way around NC Slasher above on Heaven. And they've also got Flip Jitter coming out of the back here. The timing, it favors BerserX. And oh my god, just a disgusting shot. A ripper of a shot right there from Flip Jitter. Boom, NC Slasher. He's just got nothing left in the tank except for maybe one more. Can't get onto the site, but he will be caught mid-air. Not feeling themselves right now, because they are not playing like the Boom that we know and love here. That's a good... That's a very good. That's a great showstopper right there. But he gets caught off in a little bit of an awkward spot. Fat Penguin's looking to hold the line right now. It's a
catch him off guard. Judge in hand, and he might just win this fight up close. So difficult to deal with, but Fat Penguin once again finding the opener as soon as Lmemore does the same on the A side too. They've taken control of it. He has that ultimate to get back into the spawn here of Boom Esports.
Oh, wow.
And suddenly, this is a very possible clutch.
This is a great read right here for Fat Penguin. Oh. He's gonna spot two! He only gets one, but still, it's enough! For the meantime here, Lmemore. He has been such a dominant player here. The way that he played against Cerberus was absolutely maddening. He's got the camera that spots out one. He spots out both here. But who is gonna win the duel? That's gonna be the teleport onto site, and the information is given. But he swings out a little bit wide. Still able to keep himself on the spike. Can he get it to half? He looks like he's sticking it, but Asteriskk makes the right read. Three kills. One of the players that's always getting picked off first, and it's not his fault. He's just been unable to use that. This time, however, things are different. As the two kills now go in favor of Lmemore. In the favor of Boom, as Lmemore and Fat Penguin, they go down, but still survive.
That's all they eat.
For the
most part.
With 10 seconds left, it's another great read here. Look at this. naTz, disgusting yet again. Spike plant. And how is he able to do this? Just the reads. The reads are coming in so well here. The teleport coming in from the shadows might be big. But the lockdown, it doesn't matter. It's planted, however. It's not planted for them, so they're going to have to fight their way back onto this site here because there's two players. They're a little bit out of position, but regardless of that or not, Tehbotol, he gets that final kill.
Especially for full sense, where there's only one Thailand rep. That's not a good prospect. But naTz here is going to get completely shut down. They go in and waddle through whatever defense was left as Blaze finds another kill on here. They'll be peeking into the heavens itself, taking down quite low, trying to swing on wide, get the trades off.
Tehbotol
is able to shut down Blaze. Perfect flashes to counteract everything going on here on the top of heaven. It's all down to Lmemore. He's going to have to do quite a lot to bring this one back.
I think it's possible. Lmemore, he is so good on these clutches. This is one of the rounds where you actually are a little bit worried, even though you got the plant, even though they know where he is. There's a very decent chance that Lmemore comes out on top. Never mind. So I live for this. That's a pixel of a shot, right? Because they know it's so vulnerable. Look at this wall from naTz. It's so big brain. But all right, he's gonna spot three, and on the other side of the wall, he meets his demise. Now Fat Penguin is gonna get the shot onto one. He's able to adjust to the second one. Can actually swing out to look for more, but he's worried about the presence over towards Hell, but there's going to be no one there. BerserX cleans him. A lot of it has to do with just the picks going Alter Ego's way. Not going to be one for that, though, because Boom have found a very, very nice double kill here. They might not expect Fat Penguin, and they don't. But still, kill goes Flip Jitter's way, and this is going to be a clean round here for Boom Esports.
Have a chance, and that's exactly what they do.
Yeah, they even commit the wall just to be able to hold it. Lmemore, they've swapped him over to B, and thus far he's found one. He's able to swing around the corner, and he gets a double here. But there's still a lot of work to be done. The raise available for Blaze, and he gets up NC Slasher. naTz is able to take down Asteriskk, and from the corner, Fat Penguin gets him out. Definitely running scared right now as the pressure now comes in towards Heaven. Shots will be fired in exchange, with Fat Penguin in this corner unable to get anything, and neither will Tehbotol, as flips Jadur, the double entry for him, almost the triple entry, but it's Lmemore, the neural theft before he goes down, as well as the kill! So that's gonna be a load of information, but with only one player left standing,
if defenders have. And even though that, say, B side or A side can be taken a little bit more easily, it can be retaken just as easily here. But look at this. BerserX, he gets an opening pick, and that's a nice showstopper from NC Slasher. He gets one as Fat Penguin falling to the ground. No, Penguins cannot fly. Not here. Not in split, as it's a 2v3. Tehbotol, BerserX, they're going to have a lot of work to do. They do have the Rolling Thunder. They will be utilizing that for now. Oh, it doesn't go through. Doesn't go all the way through. So that's as he throws out this Rolling Thunder. Good dash in, but it's going to be straight into Boom Asterisk's hands. And so...
in this one, at the very least.
Oh no! He unscopes, but he's... what?! How is he allowed to re-peek that? And that was a mistake that they should not have been able to get away with there. But at the end of it all, BerserX gets away with one, gets away with two, and he's now able to fall back. A little bit premature on the entry here, but still they managed to find one at least, and that's going to be even more as the Lurk coming up from heaven is able to find some success now. It's a 3v3. Eeyore, he's up close, and he loses that duel to naTz back into B main. The spike is down, so they're going to have to be a little bit decisive about where they want to push. Tehbotol's good for one. Tehbotol gets traded out, but it's still a 1v1. naTz, he did go down in the end, and he taps away. Unfortunate.
Try and find naTz VALORANT. He does go on the peak here. His head being given away, but he finds a head of his own.
Anywhere that they can head on to. But can they get the frags? Doesn't look like. Lmemore holding firm, holding fast here, and folding strong as he gets another one onto NC Slasher. The rotation denied here by naTz Lawrence. And Asterisk looking like he doesn't really have much left in it. He will pick up a gun. In this 1v4 with 6 seconds, BerserX, will he get checked? This is dangerous. False sense of security provided by the bot, by the turret, but instead, I don't think it's going to happen for now as the 4v4 does commence. Fat Penguin, not going to get checked in this corner for now. He's going to be a linchpin here. He could be absolutely massive, but BerserX, he finds a pick. Shots exchange here. Fat Penguin looking to swing off the back of that paranoia. Now BerserX trying to get onto that site here, and that's going to be up close, but right click does not connect. It's Boom that does. They land it all, and it's Lmemore here. Neural Theft coming out. 1v2. Knows where one is, but that's going to be the shrouded step to help him get out of that position here. Taps away at the spike. Can't land the shot on...
how did they do it? Boom Esports. You know, with that early mid control and them going to heaven, it seemed like they were a bit conflicted. Do we go through the vents? Do we try and split the A site? Or do we just come on in the series? This is the 10th time they've met each other. 8th in the official circuit. Oh. And Blaze just completely opening up the site, blazing a path into it, and they're looking to end the series 13-11, possibly. That will land to turn the channel to a different show because the showstopper from NC Slasher has made things a lot more difficult for AE. That just could have
been all Lmemore find something special, find a miracle, and it looks like they're hitting shots. They got information on where Eeyore is. They landed here, but in a 1v2, it's Lmemore has to come up with nothing short of the most amazing plays that he's ever come up with here. The double peek, the swing, and almost gets it!
Commit to our positions already and go for that Bravo site itself. Sky, it's been quite effective in multiple regions, but can they make it happen this time? Tehbotol opening the things up. Reyna, the Empress here to start the game off, and naTz is gonna find one. Fat Penguin, all mass considered, gets another pick, and it's a quick 5v2. They mean business coming into Haven.
They do look like they're not mucking around anymore, and this is one way of asserting their dominance. Alter Ego starting strong, not losing a single player on that take, and they're looking like they're gonna perfectly take this run.
We're gonna see a battle of wits, and everything else considered, AE opening up 2-0. They've been doing this time and time again here in this entire series, but they have yet to win that split map against Boom recently. This time though, another 2-0 start, Boom. I'm not sure if they got what in them to make it happen to Flip Jitter getting an opener, and Blaze and Flip Jitter, they all open things up. NaTz, it's all on to him to hold down the line. His Fat Penguin far removed has got a nice flank, actually.
Yeah, I think he'll be able to at least make something of this round. Actually, if he can get the timing right, never mind. Okay,
That was rather unfortunate, but if he did get that timing, that would have signaled naTz LaRant.
About AE, for them to kind of be touted as the underdog, gives him a chip on the shoulder, an edge here over the rest of the competition. Flip Jitter finding an opening pick there on Tehbotol as well, but they have a good chance, I think, of maybe being the top seed, or at least the second seed to represent C in Berlin. There are a few hurdles in the way, though, namely PaperX and Brand Esports, but either one of them can show up and make it happen for the Indonesian representatives. Flip Jitter finds BerserX, and Lmemore is going to get the trade-off. naTz, VALORANT able to do the same thing, too. Eeyore answering back. The 3v2 in the favor of Boom, man advantage-wise.
There we go. It's going to be a very, very pickup round, a very crucial round here, excuse me. But, ooh, all right, Lmemore yet again. We said that he was a player to watch out for. Have two to isolate. Can he actually go ahead and do that right now? He gets onto site. He finds one. He knows where one is. Can he isolate yet again? Has the turret to play with, but he knows the timing, and although Lmemore was able to play around the turret, asteriskk.
Rotation has been pulled already to the Bravo and Charlie sites, but Garage is where they're gonna try and park themselves and maybe kind of stage and mount this attack on the C site itself. NC Slash has been really good on the platform, but BerserX is able to find one, and NC Slash able to find one of his own. naTz LaRant able to get the frag, but Eeyore is gonna answer back for a 3v3. NC Slash taken down off of the whiff! And quickly, it's all onto Flip Jitter here in the 1v3. He's got the blades, but can he slice and dice this up?
He spotted the shoulder onto one. He's got an operator. He was... Now, this is a very dangerous prospect here. Do you want to try to at least use the blades? Down, it's not really going to hamper anybody from pushing into it. They still have to deal with asteriskk, who might be able to get a good pickoff right now. Jitter with a stinger, Blaze, excuse me, with a stinger, is able to get one from up close, and Flip Jitter doing work with that operator. Is able to find one through the smoke regardless, and Tehbotol completely unaware, off guard. Lmemore yet again
30 seconds left.
Is able to make things a little bit interesting, and Fat Penguin, they don't want to plant just yet. They have full access towards the C site, but they want to make sure that nobody's hanging around in Garage. Eeyore, though, is a little bit too wise for this. And a couple of Hunter's Fury will be exchanged, and yet again, it's going to be another Hunter's Fury war! This time, Blaze comes out ahead.
And strike thunder from up above, down below, and in that case, it's going to be Blaze winning that fight for Lightning. Fat Penguin, all weight is on him, and that's not a joke on what this man can bring, because we know he is a very clutch player too. He brings it to a 1v1. There he goes. And now Flip Jitter is out in the open. He does get the round. They do usually are able to get on the C site because of it, but oh, just barely escaping by, and BerserX finding the pick on asteriskk, who's none the wiser.
The confidence to peek through the tightest of angles like that to come out on top. NC Slasher, he hasn't been found yet! He's gotta get one before he drops. Okay, they look at each other, just a couple of seconds here, but Flip Jitter, he's got a good flank in, but the Seekers is going to deny. Now they know where he is, but still, it's a good position for a punish. Now the flashes does come out, it's, have a little bit of information, but Flip Jitter, he just can't win that duel at least. Wait or not, they're proving that they have... Oh, that thought! A disgusting peek right there from Blaze. He hasn't done it before. And catch, and he does it again!
Keeping Alter Ego at bay for the most part. SMG's here for the side of Boom, and Flip Jitter is going to be punished as he tries to go for the beak with a Bulldog. Lmemore finding another. Now, AE, they're making it into a one eco, and into a thrifty round in their sake. And for Boom, it's just been crumbling. There it goes, Blaze being taken down, the only player with an actual rifle in his hands. We have seen in this series that whoever wins the first opening half as Blaze opens things up here in Tehbotol, and Flip Jitter is going to find and do the same thing. Fat Penguin returning the favor on the Blaze, getting that trade-off. It's a 4v3. As I was saying, you know, whoever wins the first half hasn't been closing out the game and has been losing that map specifically. And so, if things are a sign to come, then as NC Slasher gets that pick, Boom might just make something happen at the end of it. With that operator, it kind of works against what they're trying to make happen. So NC Slasher has been playing this back of the site quite amicably, as naTz is going to be taken down. Blaze finding two opening picks, and BerserX will find one, but the quick trade-off here coming from NC Slasher. Fat Bang was able to find one of his own on the Blaze, and he finds a double Q on the ER. NC Slasher holding it down, holding down the line. It's a 1v1 right now. Gonna have to be forced off of the plant because of the lockdown here. Shall expire. He has just enough time to rotate to either site, but I'm not sure if that's exactly what he's gonna go for. Gonna pull up the cosmic divide.
That's a great wall.
Oh, but will he be able to plant off of that? I don't think so.
Yeah, he can. There is a space. I think there's a space towards the left that he can actually just plant on. Yeah,
you're right.
Yeah, that's absolutely massive. That's really a great wall to be able to play. Now he could literally be anywhere. And just like
that. Oh, no, he misses! That's the problem with the Phantom, ladies and gentlemen.
Boom Esports are already on the site. They've given it up. They can go for the plant here. And somehow Eeyore just shuts naTz down.
Massive pick to find here, especially on a round that they very much desperately need. They want to be able to level things here 7-7, and this is going to skyrocket their chances if they can secure this round. They do have a flank coming in. Oh no, they don't have a flank coming in. It's going to be Blaze all the way into the back, but it doesn't matter because boom, Tehbotol as well. But on the other side, you got like people like Blaze popping off. But before I get into that, a little bit of an awkward situation is the gravity well makes things difficult for AE, and yet again BerserX will find one, but it's still brought to a 2v3. There's a lot of ground to cover on this retake, but they're creeping up here. Asteriskk, oh no, he gets caught, but he still manages to win the duel. That's a big miss right there from BerserX.
Oh,
they might not expect naTz here, who's worked his way around the corner, but he won't expect Blaze, who's worked his way.
They now try to secure that site. They haven't dealt with Fat Penguin. Spotted out here looking for information, but Fat Penguin, Tehbotol to back him up. He gets one here, and the spike has not been planted. The pressure just absolutely mounting here towards that B side, and they're gonna be trying to find anything they can. Tehbotol doing work, getting another 3v2 here. Dash coming out just to get out of that spot, and naTz ready for the backup, but Asteriskk is good for the refrag. 1v2, they don't want to make a mistake here. They're gonna be playing very passively. That's gonna be a nice tag. With a trail,
flashes abound, and they're trying to make the A site theirs. Tehbotol, he can dismiss out of safety here, but he's not even going to get the opportunity to do so because they've completely overrun the site here, Boom Esports. Now, suddenly, a quick 5v2 seems to have been taking a back shot.
Here, in a best of three, it's a very much a different story. Now, forces here for Boom Esports. They're going to be gathering towards A. We start an entry. They haven't closed off this angle yet. naTz is good for one. The crossfire falls apart as the two members holding A just completely get decimated here. It's Alter Ego have lost round after round after round, and this might be another save call. I wouldn't blame them if they do go for it. They might send Fat Penguin off to just go and die. This is just the way to sugarcoat it. They're going to send him to go for an
That's
eco.
Your mission.
Yeah, that is their mission. Take one down with you.
Die.
Die.
I mean, that's all he can really do at that point.
And because he needs to, because he doesn't want to have no money coming to the next round.
Quite literally, like, no memes intended. He maybe find one, go for the exit, and that he shall not do, unfortunately, for Alter Ego. I thought he had that one in the bag with Blaze not.
The fact that it normally has. I think a lot of it has to do. Oh, wait, hold on. The timing just not going for Lmemore's way, and that's a massive, massive chance here. Flips Jadur. Completely blind.
Oh no, it's so awkward. They get through Fat Penguin, and there's three members right now honing in on the site. BerserX yet again misses an opportunity here. 3v4. naTz very low on HP, and they lose all the remaining members here except for two, as naTz and Tehbotol have to make magic. And against four, it's not gonna happen, as Boom Esports are able to claim. It is so difficult to see them digging themselves out of it.
I don't really see that happening, honestly. Four rounds, perfect that they have to play in. They keep out of the series. Plant will go down on the Bravo site. Nothing that AE are going to do to stop that from happening. Pushing out Lmemore. He's going to get caught out in transition. As a spike is planted, the gravity well will pull him off guard. And Blaze finding a second, even with a soap, by initiating everything and getting the frags. But Tehbotol answering back. Asteriskk on the refrag here to find BerserX in a 4v1, making it happen. But in the end, he will dismiss the safety for the meantime. It's a 1v3. Can he clutch this one out?
It's, I don't know, man. 1v3, it might be too much to ask here. The astral, the cosmic divide, just proving it to be so difficult.
Maybe get a round or two here, but let's see the action before we really call it, Illustrado. They have four chances